नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, इंडिविजुअल्स इन वेरियस डोमेन्स, आई वॉज गोइंग थ्रू वन ऑफ द वीडियोज ऑफ लाइव वीडियोज ऑफ ताडेपल्ली सर. इट वॉज रियली a very good question that he had indirectly asked to the researchers or the scholars before even getting into the questions or getting into his aspects of or his understanding. As a part of note and disclaimer, whatever that I am telling in this video or speaking about it is beyond a point of kalapam. When I say beyond a point of kalapam, it is beyond nitya and anitya aspect. However, I wanted to touch upon two aspects in this. One is Siddhendra Yogi's advent in Kuchipudi. Second is existence or transcribing of the Smritis in the form of dance form. That doesn't mean I'm going to touch the intricacies or the practical applications, because I am not a professional dancer, but I can talk about it over and above that from the theoretical aspect. Though this is my understanding of what exactly may or might have happened. It could be correct, it may not be correct, or it may vary from the thought process of the individual scholars in their respective domains. To start with, let's try understanding a few verses of Hiranyagarbha Sutta. कस्मै देवाय हविषा विधेम. दिस इज वन ऑफ द वेरी कॉमन लाइन दट कम्स इन द हिरण्यगर्भ सूक्त. हियर का मीन्स निर्गुण ब्रह्म और देर इज नो फॉर्म एट ऑल. दिस इज way back around 10,000 to 15,000 years. Yo devasva adhideva eka asit. Yo devasva adhideva eka asit. He is the gods of the gods. None besides him. He is Prajapati. This is what has been told or as per Smritis which were transcribed from the Shrutis in Vedas. Now, the concept of golden womb in the Vishwakarma Sutta has been one of the proofs. Now, novel of the Supreme Cosmic Creator, All things exist. All things existing later, they were transferred to Vishnu. That's the reason why we call it as Vishnu Maya. And Upanishads calls it in the soul of the universe or Brahman. That is knower of Brahma as a whole, floated in the emptiness and the darkness of the non-existence. Now, why am I talking about this? One may ask, and definitely one should ask. When we talk about Kalapam or Bhama Kalapam, it is an act. It is a kind of dance drama wherein we are portraying about Satyabhama and Sri Krishna and getting that Advaita philosophy of Adi Shankaracharya. The point is, here when we talk about Advaita philosophy, the Shaivism or Shaivagama predominantly plays a key role in Advaita philosophy, because Shankara or Shakta or Purusha, who is pervading, he is responsible for Srushti, Laya, Jati and Gati. At the same time, getting that 36 tattvas into the being in reference to the body, mind and soul consciousness aspect. Here, after having gone through many of the literatures, one thing what I have seen is, we talk about Eko Purushaha Narayana. Narayana is the one God. On other hand, we talk about Brahma or Brahman consciousness over here, getting in the psyche or the psychological or the psychosis aspects of the individual personality from the perspective of ego concept or understanding as a personality. Because here Satyabhama, being a central character, having that nature, you know, I am beautiful, I know everything. She is very possessive about everything. At the same time, she is like having the ego that she is only the beautiful lady on this earth. In the end, she understands her fault, or she realizes that she is committing mistakes, and thus she comes in terms of universal truth. Now, when we talk about what was the reason for Siddhendra Yogi, as per literatures, as per documented evidence, or as per the authors who have been doing it for a longer time, if we really look at it, it is more or less like creating awareness in the society that one should not get carried away with this 36 universal truths, which by default are self-imbibed into the one person's character, whether he or she. The point is, the question of Siddhendra Yogi most of us have a question most of us have a thought that it's like some kind of I would rather put it like confusion. I would say it confusion. As per my assumption, I am not trying to find others' inferences. But as per my inference, if I really see, Siddhendra Yogi, if some are telling he was from 11th century, he was from 13th century, some say 14th century, I have seen 15th century also. If I really look at the history or the reason of Bhama Kalapam or the thematic understanding of Bhama Kalapam, it has touched upon various eras of post-Vedic, or I can say it as pre-Vedic era, when Hiranyagarbha Sutta was in Shruti form. And other very important question that should come into the minds of scholars is that Siddhendra Yogi, Abhinava Gupta, Anandavardhana, Acharya Charaka, these people were on contrary from the Shaiva Gama or Shaiva aspect. And there is one other note, which one other very interesting point which I was seeing today. I don't know whether it is correct, right or wrong, from the documented evidence. He is from Chintas clan. Now, the question is, if Siddhendra Yogi was from the 11th century, how come he indirectly brought the meaning of Kasmai Devaya Havisha Vidhema and Yo Devasya Adhi Deva Eka Asit? He is gods of the gods, none besides him. He is none other than Prajapati. Now this is very critical question that scholars need to understand. I thought of sharing this because I am still like, I just wanted to keep it as an open-ended question wherein I may be wrong, I may not be wrong. because this is what my understanding goes about. And on the other hand, it talks about Eko Purushaha Narayanaha. And Vishnu. As I was watching Tadepalli sir's video very well, he had got a very valid point. Be it Bhama Kalapam, Golla Kalapam, or any literature, any dance drama by Sithindra Yogi, it's based on the Advaita philosophy. Now the question of, if he was from the 11th century, let's say, then the bhakti movement was at its peak. It didn't, primary stage or the budding stage. And even the Shiva Tattvas were at core. They were being practiced by the individuals by and large. And coming to the point of Bhagavatars who believe in God. Are these people from the post-Vedic era? Is one question which I have got, which I wanted to know. After seeing this video, if anyone who is watching can give an answer to this, I would be more than happy. Though this is not a conclusive evidence that I have come up. If he was from the 13th century, already that psyche, psychosis and psychological elements of the human existence were inscribed and imbibed by default, and they were being followed. My point is, if people are telling Siddhendra Yogi is from 11th century or 13th century or 14th century, some people say even 15th century. I have seen some more articles wherein it is talking from the 17th century, between 11th and 17th century. Then, how is he talking about Advaita philosophy? Is the one question which I had. If I really look at the series of incidents or series of happenings right from post-Vedic era, if I really look at the post-Vedic era, Varnas were not there. Nothing like Bhagavatars or Bhagavatulu or any kind of that. As per Vedic traditions, I see only Srauta, Dharma, and Gruhya. So, question of Siddhendra Yogi's existence still remains a question mark. Now, why are we not able to ascertain his existence? I will explain why. To explain you, let me take you through one of the anecdote. There was a person, individual, who went to Shirdi, asked Sai Baba, and he was more interested in knowing his existence or his birth date, because he wanted to take the astrology of Sai Baba. Sai Baba remained silent. He didn't say anything. He just asked, "Why do you want? What is it that you want?" "I want to write your astrology." "What is astrology?" He asked a simple question. The devotee could not answer. Devotee could understand why he asked this question. Every one of us have one specific purpose. Sorry about that. Every one of us, be it seers, be it sages, be it rishis, be it munis or brahmarishis. Here is where granthas or scriptures came into existence. And this is where one needs to understand. In the pre-Vedic era, when they were creating a civilization or creating a society, they used to follow Agni Devata. And their main god was Indra. And slowly, civilization and society started increasing its width by and large. By the time this post Vedic era was done with, maybe 1 millennium years back, or maybe 1000 to 2000 years back, or even more, whatever figures that I am giving is approximate, by the way, because whatever that I have seen in the literature. The point is, when we talk about the existence of the yogis, rishis, munis, brahmarishis, or self-realized person, a realized soul, the age, birth year, age, place of birth, these three will not really matter. What is the core message that we are giving through the enactment? Even for that matter, the Natya Shastra which we are seeing today, to my assumption of my research work, all the scholars, including Tadepalli sir, says Bharata had written. I will say it is not Bharata who has written. It is written by many seers. They made it one single text by adding and by doing additions and deletions, wherein they included the various aspects of Vedas, like various aspects of Vedas, like taking into consideration Krishna Yajurveda aspect and Shukla Yajurveda aspect, and taking into consideration the Samhitas, which included mantras and benedictions, Aranyakas, which included rituals, sacrifices and symbolic sacrifices, Brahmanas, from the viewpoint of Brahma and Brahma concept, which dealt with commentaries on rituals, ceremonies and sacrifices, and then Upanishads, which included meditation, philosophy, spiritual knowledge, and then Upasanas, worships. Now, one may ask, on what basis you are talking about this? If I really look at Brahmanas, it talks about commentaries on rituals, ceremonies and sacrifices. That's what you do when you perform indirectly. And Samhitas, mantras and benedictions, mantras in the forms of lyrics, meditation, philosophy, spiritual knowledge, whole of this gamut of whatever that I am talking about now, this is what is given in the form of structured and schematic way using the stories of Puranas or mythology. Myth plus eology, mythology, wherein it gives the detailed understanding of the 36 tattvas, or by way of stories. It could be what you call Bhama Kalapam, it could be Golla Kalapam, it could be other story, or it could be Satya Harishchandra story, it could be Rukmini Kalyanam, it could be Maya Bazaar, etc., etc. Like this, if I go, there will be many things. Now, when whole of this gamut is there, like which I am talking about, all of this is coming from the Vedic and Upanishads way of understanding. And here there is one more very interesting point which I came across today morning when I was like looking at the practical geographical orientation of Kuchipudi. Before even getting into, I saw Kuchelapura, Kuchelapuram, etc., etc. It was talking about Satavahana period, that is in the 3rd century BC, first quarter of 3rd century AD, between 200 BC to 200 AD. Now, if we really look at these findings or these dates, and if I go with the Vedic dating, post-Vedic dating, it is something like coming to post-Vedic Vedic datings, maybe 5,000 years back. Aranyaka came around 700 to 500 BC. Brahmanas came around 1000 to 800 BC. And Srotas, etc., all of these came only after what you call Smritis came. Maybe Smritis came post Vedic era. Now what one needs to understand from these dates is that to ascertain the exact date of Siddhendra Yogi's existence, I can say maybe before 11th century. Because Shaivagama came into existence. Shaivagama, which came into existence from Kashmir. One is at Kashmir. They talk about the Kashmir aspect. And there is one more very interesting point added over here. In Tamil Nadu, there is one more Shaivagama. Shaiva aspect. So on what basis are we really looking at is one of the very biggest question. And there is one more very interesting point which I wanted to add to this. I had read one of the articles wherein it was talking about Siddhendra Yogi going to Sholapur. And Siddhendra Yogi being in Udipi. Siddhendra Yogi in Kashi. Kashi is a pretty old place. It's a very oldest place. Now, basing on whatever that assumptions that I have given, if I really look at, I can say maybe Siddhendra Yogi's existence came into picture before even 11th century, as per my assumptions after going through all of this literature or whatever chronological order dates that I have given. As a part of note and disclaimer, this is not a conclusive evidence or this is not a conclusion. This is just my assumption. And on the other hand, to ascertain the date and time of realized souls like Siddhendra Yogi or Sai Baba, Shirdi Sai Baba, or Rishis, Munis, Brahma Rishis, Rama. Of course, people are coming up with astrological charts, etc., etc. I don't really think so. It's so easy to come up. Because they are Karana Janmas, they are Avadhutas, and I am not denying that maybe the story of Siddhendra Yogi in Kuchipudi, in Kuchelapura, his family background, etc., etc., which was there, it could be correct. But if I really look at this chronology or these findings, I feel Siddhendra Yogi is a Karana Janma or Avadhuta who came into existence to exactly imbibe or inscribe or give the brief gist of the Vedic and pre and post Vedic and Upanishadic summary, and thus create a renaissance in the society by way of creating that divinity in the society when there was so much political unrest, the societal unrest, civilization unrest. By the way, there is one more reference that I want to give over here. When Advaita philosophy was introduced by Adi Shankaracharya, there was social and political and civil unrest during the period of Advaita philosophy when Adi Shankaracharya introduced to the society. Thus it remains an open-ended question. Thus I conclude this video with an open-ended question. Considering these facts, now what is that scholars or someone who is doing research in the understanding of birth of Siddhendra Yogi, is, if these are the assumptions, can we ascertain the date? This is not a conclusive evidence. This is not the conclusion that I am giving. This is just, these are my findings which I came across and I wanted to share with one and all. Thus I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Shri Guru Purna. May the Guru's grace be with all. Have a nice day ahead. As a part of note and disclaimer, I may be correct, I may not be correct. Please do correct me. I am also a human being. These are just my findings. I am not coming to conclusions. This is not a conclusive. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life.